The EpiPen is an auto-injector which administers adrenaline and is carried by people who have been diagnosed with anaphylaxis. As such, they can be used if the person goes into anaphylactic shock. Two types are available, the EpiPen and the EpiPen Junior. To avoid accidents and to prevent damage in the EpiPen, it should always be kept in its case when not in use. There are easy to read instructions down the side of each pen, and these should be consulted every time one is used, even if you've used them before, to remind you of exactly what to do and to ensure that there haven't been any changes in regulations or use. The blue cap at the top of the EpiPen is the safety cap, which makes sure that the needle does not accidentally protrude when not in use. Once this cap is removed, the unit is live. The cap can be replaced without the EpiPen being used, however you must do so carefully as you could inject yourself accidentally with adrenaline. When using an EpiPen, you should first remove it from its case and then sit down or lie down if you feel dizzy, with your legs slightly raised to keep the blood flowing. If you're having difficulty in breathing, then just sit down. Then remove the safety cap and swing the auto-injector into the thigh. This can be done through clothing, but make sure that the needle will not have to go through any thick seams or anything in pockets. Once the needle has been discharged, hold it in place for 3 seconds and then remove it. Stay where you are until the emergency services arrive, or if you're treating someone and they're unconscious, place them in a recovery position. When the EpiPen has been used, a needle cover will appear automatically over the needle to prevent any further needle injuries. The used EpiPen should be given to the emergency services after use so they can see exactly what's been administered to the patient, and they can also dispose of it correctly. Should a second dose be required, repeat the process and make sure again that you give them both to the emergency services.